business and industry credentials. We say that we want students to be career and college ready. Well, one of the things that we've done over the last few years is we've implemented a very strong credentialing program in our schools. Last year in North Carolina, we had over 160,000 business and industry recognized credentials earned by our CTE students in our high schools. For those that are familiar, I give a good example. Bladen County, Elizabethtown, 134% of their students that were eligible to earn a credential earned a credential. So what does that mean? That means that for every one of their students that could get a credential, each one of them earned about one and a half credentials. What does that do to prepare them to enter into the workforce and to be equipped to enter in that pipeline? Well, it gives them a credential in hand. Those credentials can be a credential such as the work keys credential that was talked about earlier this morning. I know David talked about that was one of the criteria for those students that were applying for that CPT program, that they had to have a silver level. Well, that is the level that we expect our students to achieve when they do the work keys in the high school. Every CTE concentrator is given an opportunity to take that work keys assessment, and we provide that to them at no charge.